John.
We are on. So, call the meeting to order at 6:35, something like that, 6:34. And first thing we've got are minutes from March 28th and March 30th, so take a quick look at those.
I'll say you do a beautiful job on minutes.
Yes, you do.
Coming to an end, please.
Anytime you get complimented on minutes, you're in trouble.
Did we actually meet the 29th or Thursday?
I had minutes, first of the minute.
I was thinking it was the 29th.
The 29th was Wednesday.
That would know the selectmen, so second meeting minutes of the 29th?
29th, right, instead of 30th.
Okay.
My husband's sister.
Oh, good. Oh, that's a big crowd, a big crowd, Charles. It was a big crowd at Charles.
On Sunday?
Yeah, yes, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, all my kids are home.
Should I say a couple of corrections?
Sure.
Even though on.
Whatever, these were really tough, because they were.
On March 28th?
Yep.
You got me as making the motion.
Again?
For the OPED funding.
Yeah.
And I don't.
You didn't do it, huh?
I don't believe it was me, because I'm totally against it.
Okay. JPAC. Did you do?
You can blame me if you want.
I don't care, it doesn't matter who, it's just.
The OPED, it should be OPED.
As long as it's fixed.
Yeah, it's OPED.
Bruce.
OPED.
OPED?
Yeah.
I just don't want somebody.
B.
They want.
I don't want somebody to think I was for it when I am steadfast against it.
Bad. That's good. Yep, I appreciate that.
Any other corrections?
Okay, one more minute. Yeah, the wastewater treatment plant salaries. You have me as seconding it? I opposed. I'm the one vote that said no.
Yep, got it.
Sorry, but.
No, fine.
Going to take the blame for that?
I don't care.
I don't know what you're doing to me here, Bruce.
What am I doing, what I put you again?
March 30th?
Wait.
No, we're not there.
We're not there yet, okay.
Actually, it's 29th, I think.
We'll do that.
I just like typing those initials, I guess.
Okay.
Make a motion, we accept the March 28th minutes.
Second.
As corrected.
As corrected.
Moved and seconded to accept the minutes as corrected for March 28th. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous?
Yep.
And the minutes for March 30th?
29th.
That's to March 29th.
29th, right.
What did I get you on the wastewater expense?
I think you're out to get me. Yeah, the WTP expense.
Yep.
What is that?
A little sloppy, yeah.
Pretty tough with all the conversations we had going.
I abstained.
When?
March 29th. Oh, wait a minute, maybe that goes back to the original one. Maybe, okay, no, disregard what I said.
Today's the fourth.
Today's the fifth.
Yep. So the next meeting day is April 5th, not 4th.
Let me see.
No, it's the fourth today.
Fourth is today.
Fourth.
Okay, okay.
I think it's the fourth.
Yeah, it is fourth.
So that's correct.
Yep.
Okay.
Make a motion, we accept them. March 29th minutes.
Moved?
Seconded.
Moved and seconded. All those in favor accept the minutes as corrected?
Aye.
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 All those opposed? Unanimous. There are requests to take a look at a couple of budgets that we had looked at before and either said no to or so.
Or in the case of the FEG access where we didn't have one yet.
But at the Energy Committee, or the Energy Budget was one, we'll find it here someplace, the Energy Committee. So I said, take a look at it. We were asked to take a look at the mosquitoes too, and I said, no, we're not looking at that. So. Anything on the Energy Committee?
Yeah, we're only doing it to 300 homes, not everybody.
Well, actually, there's a site on the town website that Bruce emailed us a copy of. And it says that the three towns that are involved, they're gonna rank them three, one, two, and three, three being the most least energy efficient. They take the 20,000 least energy efficient households in those three towns, and somebody was going to mail out that information.
You didn't get it, John?
What's that?
The
email? The other three towns.
No, I found on town website.
They are, they're really huge.
And I sent it out, I thought, I sent it to you. This is maybe right after our last meeting, some information on that.
If I did, I might have been when I was, I don't remember.
No.
Well, the permit, I don't know what two, other two cities it were. I don't remember.
Doesn't matter.
There was nothing Western Mass.
Okay.
So they're gonna mail the 300 homes, not everybody. They're gonna do everybody, but then mail the 300?
Well, they're figuring they're gonna be 300 out of the 20,000.
I don't remember exactly.
It was 20,000 households would be. Somebody was going to send it. I didn't think the town had to send it.
It didn't sound like the town.
Sounded like.
All right, I don't want to spend a lot of time on it.
Okay. I don't agree.
One thing, do you have some input on that particular thing, Brenda?
We've got this here.
We have a lot of.
No, I meant as far as funding, what you had told me today, that they supposedly got in a previous grant?
Well, I've been told that Wendy discussed it with them, and they're going to keep that money back for Beth Greenblatt because they need to renew that contract for her to do the RFP again.
How many times are you going to do it?
Last time.
Huh?
The town didn't pursue it last time.
So did we pay her?
We paid her some, I think.
We did pay her some. Like $1,000, I can't remember.
Oh.
Some, like,
what is she charging?
I don't know.
I see we have an RFP, and I would just ask her to update it when we're ready to do that. So just don't know what it's going to cost.
How much money did we appropriate last time?
I don't know.
We had a grant.
I
Yeah, did we use the Green Communities money?
In 2013, I believe, we set aside $3,000 for her, and we've spent...
$1,000.
$1,000, basically, out of that appropriation. We just continue carrying that appropriation forward. I know at one point we were talking about a bigger contract with her for something, and I don't remember what any of that was, and there was supposed to be...
Yeah, last year, there was some other contract with her.
But I know nothing about that one. I don't know if that contract ever went through. So at this point, the only thing I know of in the books is that one line item, of which that's the amount that's left.
So we have $2,000, which might not be enough.
Well, and so there's some money in the Green Communities grant that's left to be able to cover the rest of it. So we just wanted to make sure that there was enough for that purpose, separate from what they're asking for with all this. If that makes sense.
I have no idea what that is.
Did I?
All right, so...
Whatever.
Yep, and that was voted.
Anyone want to take another look at this?
So we don't need to do it.
And...
Thanks.
For the Energy Committee?
Yeah.
Make a motion that we authorize $1,000 for expenditure of the Energy Committee.
Motion, is there a second?
No, second for discussion.
Okay, there's a second.
That means we've got at least one vote.
The handouts.
Yeah, probably two. So...
What?
Brenda?
No, the handouts.
Did you have anything you wanted to add to this?
The details of how they're going to spend.
Wendy?
Do you have the details of what they've requested before you?
Yeah.
No, I mean, all the other handouts he sent us.
There's a letter behind it.
There's a letter here.
There's a letter behind it.
And the only other thing was the one trifold that I can stick a copy of, if you notice here, if you need to.
Okay, thanks. Is this yours or mine?
And one of the things that I was concerned about was whether we might possibly be bumping up against our ability to afford the... And it looks like, and we'll talk about that shortly, and it looks like we are in decent financial shape, so... I'll change my...
I'm surprised that you can run a program for $1,000 or under.
I don't imagine.
And I think until somebody proves that they're going to mismanage money, we should give them a break and let them try running it.
What about the issue of privacy?
What about privacy?
I was concerned about that.
You take a picture of a house.
Looks like they're already doing it.
You mail it out.
Taking the pictures.
Big deal, what's a big deal?
Because everybody's going to know you're one of three. You're one of the 300 houses that has poor insulation.
Who's going to know that?
You're on the bottom. It's going to be public record.
Who's going to know that? How are they going to know that? I don't even know what the forms look like. Do you know what the forms look like?
No, but it's public information.
Big deal.
One of the line items...
Everybody walks down the street, there's all kinds of security cameras on. Today, with public security, we shouldn't even worry about it.
There's $160 in there to mail out 300 homes.
Mary's been trying to make a comment over here.
Yeah, sorry, Mary.
Go ahead.
I just said it, one of the line items is for other projects anticipated. That's the larger dollar amount. So that doesn't mean it's just for that project.
Understood.
Yeah, so...
And my other question is, are we adding another line item to the budget? Is this going to be a continuation on an annual basis from here?
We've got a historical commission. They always put in for $1,000. What do they spend it on?
Just asking.
I know.
I think it's worth doing. Let's see what we get for it.
I think I'm willing to try it.
We don't like what we get.
I'll vote for it again, and everybody can vote no, and that's fine.
Town accountant and I will monitor expenses.
You're going to monitor expenses?
We will.
Okay, good.
We will.
There you go. All right, any other discussion?
With that promise, we've got to vote for it now.
There you go. There's no further discussion. All of those in favor? Aye. Raise your hand so I can see. That's three of us. Mary, two?
Four. You have to count Mary.
Four. All those opposed?
So it's 4-3.
4-3-0.
Yep.
Okay.
Well, we can do an easy one now, Peg Access.
I don't know if that's so easy.
Yeah, it's pretty easy.
It's designated from Comcast, we've got to do something with it.
It's designated for, specifically for capital items for Peg Access, so.
It's money that we actually received this year that's earmarked specifically for Peg Access capital. So Skip's recommendation last time was to just set up an appropriation for the capital line item, and then they can use it as they need to. And I thought that made sense, because then we keep track of it.
Good.
He did give us a.
You mean he has good ideas?
What's that?
He has good ideas?
He does, every once in a while.
Okay.
Chris did put together a nice list of things that he wanted to purchase with that capital this year, and it comes out to $23,700 worth.
That's a good start.
This is essentially what, this is in our license agreement that was just signed, you probably remember this, but.
So what happens to this next June 30th?
It'll be a continuing appropriation, so whatever he doesn't spend, we'll continue, we'll carry it forward for the next year.
And in the license agreement, I believe we get 11, we share, it used to go direct, or in some communities it goes direct. I wanted it to come through the town, so we make sure the money comes in, and we watch what it's being spent on. And then when it looks like there's money to ask for certain things we know we need, and we've talked about this, and I think it's in some of his items there, more mics for our big meetings and big groups, big committees where we need more mics at the table. I've also asked for whatever equipment we need to develop the capacity to save everything, because we're going, everything is, we don't have everything going back for years for meetings that have been broadcast, cable casts. So this will give us the capacity to keep that. So there are the things I'm talking about and what our needs are and how to integrate what they're doing in with what we need.
So you'll handle all the procurement, you'll handle?
Nope, that's theirs. It becomes their money, they get the money and they.
It's just a pass-through, really?
It is a pass-through, I mean, in some communities, you, they actually give them the money, and they don't even come through the town. This is a way of our monitoring. So we get capital money and in our license agreement, and we can have what we call a grant agreement directly with the cable access provider. We also get quarterly payments for 50 cents per subscriber, and they, that's operating revenues that they bill us for. We don't turn it all over, we keep some of it and give them some of that, based on their budget for the three, for their overall operations. So we'll get the $50,000 this year, I'm being totally transparent, I believe $11,000 in the second year, and $4,000 for the remaining 8 years of the license agreement, for capital items.
Where does it come from?
Comcast.
Comcast.
Comcast?
It's our license agreement for.
It's the money that you pay into Comcast, right?
Everybody.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know, I don't, everybody, yeah, I.
Subscribes to cable.
Yeah.
Well, the quarterly amounts that we get, but the capital is a, it's what, that's our agreement with them.
I'd like to make a motion, we approve that, we're wasting time on something that has no dollar effect.
Make sure you get that right now.
I think I got it.
Second.
No, that.
That makes it easy.
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? 7-0.
Yep.
7-0-0. Let's see, maturing debt. This is an amendment, so go ahead.
You've seen this before, and we now have a figure or a better idea of what our school roof loan will be in the end. And so we figured a debt service on that based on keeping a loan for 8 years.
In other words, we anticipate at this point.
Correct.
That our portion of it will be in addition to what we've already paid, in addition to what the gifts that we will receive, that the town will end up paying $800,000 for the roof.
That's a bargain.
Why isn't the principal going up as you make payments of interest, you know, it's, is it a level monthly payment?
With the bond premium, it is. Or excuse me, the garage premium, yes, or the garage bond, yes. And with this, we're just taking out temporary loans, so we figured we'd pay off $100,000 this year. Maybe we continue to pay off $100,000 every year, maybe we change that figure.
Oh, okay.
We're just renewing it on a yearly basis.
Make a motion, we approve maturing debt.
Seconded.
$440,000.
It's moved, seconded. Any further discussion? There is none. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried, 7-0.
Did we go by the skip, the swim program skip?
I might have, and I was looking, yeah, there it is. Swim program. This is back again, right? We did talk about this, and I don't remember whether we'd said no to it or we asked for.
We had reduced, we reduced it.
I believe we approved it for $8,000 instead of the $8,960.
Okay.
We've been talking about the swim program revolving fund and how that exists, and maybe some of us have been discussing that, so I'll just give you a brief little overview. We have a swim program revolving fund. It just collects the money from when they do swimming lessons. There have been some expenditures out of there in the past, but very few. We haven't had anything since 2014. There is, I believe, about $11,600 left in that account right now. Bruce, is that the number?
I don't remember exactly.
$11,040?
Okay.
Never mind, sorry, sorry.
So anyway, we take in about $1,600, $1,700 a year in swim program income. So I was thinking that we could reduce this budget for this year by like $4,900 and bring that revolving fund back to a balance that is a little more reasonable.
Make a motion, we approve summer swim program salaries for $4,000.
Second.
It's moved and seconded. Any further discussion? There's none. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? 7-0. Capital request. I'm going to turn this over to you, John. This is essentially the capital improvement committees.
I don't know what I'm talking about.
The capital improvement committee approved. Do you want me to go line by item?
Sure, go ahead.
Why don't we just do the exception?
Okay.
All right. Approved all of these except the stretch of load systems. And for that, we approved one at $25,000 at the committee as a whole. That's what it was. So that's what the capital improvement planning committee did.
Yeah.
All right, that's, everything's good except the $50,000. We approved $25,000.
That's right, John, I forgot.
As a committee.
Yes.
But while there was discussion that there were people that said what the capital improvement planning committee does is only a recommendation to the select board, so maybe the select board wants $50,000? I don't know.
I think that's what they approved at the meeting last Wednesday night.
Yes, they did.
And I think the finance.
We did too.
Yes, the finance committee voted, and the select board voted the $50,000.
Okay.
That was the stretcher is part of South County EMS.
Yep.
Right.
And it's coming directly out of their retained earnings.
Yeah, all of that's coming from retained earnings, so I believe, I think we voted as part of their budget, so in their budget, it says $50,000.
That's correct.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
So what we're really voting on are the items above South County. I mean, South County's in there, but the $49,500 is the sum total of the one, two, three, four, five items.
We correct the town clerk voting machine, what she had in her budget?
I don't know.
What's your account number?
Did she have it in her budget?
She has her budget also.
Did she, in the operating?
Yep. It's a different number, too.
You sure?
I think we took it out.
I think so, too, but I do remember.
I have to go back and remember.
What's the question?
The town clerk's budget, Barbara put it in, put this in both budgets.
No, she had taken it out.
Right, and so we basically took it out of her operating budget.
I thought we did, we voted it out.
Exactly.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, I don't see it.
Oh, 60, the 65.
Yeah, so it's now a capital.
Oh, it is a capital.
So my question is, above the skims adds up to a lot more than 49.5.
Yeah.
No.
It does.
No, it's 49.5.
49.5.
Huh?
Huh?
From here up, 49.5.
39.5. 45.5.
That's 49.5.
Oh, okay, yeah, all right, sorry.
It's the new math, Bruce.
Yep.
Yeah, okay.
He's just used to putting his bills together, and they always add up to more.
And the generator?
I gave that up years ago.
The generator, are we talking about the generator or not? Did you want to?
We can talk about the generator, sure. I don't know a whole lot about it, so I'm going to let those of you who know about the generator talk about the generator.
Well, we've been talking about a generator. We have one that's real old, and it does part of a job in the police station area, part of the job over here, but doesn't provide electricity and heat for both sides of the building in the event of need to use the generator. So we have received some estimates for approximately, I'm waiting for the final one, but probably $53,000, something like that. And John and I, Chief John and I, were talking about dividing that up, perhaps. It's too much to do the exterior work, padding a pad out there for the placement of a generator, and then the following year to actually install the generator with, you know, with the build, with an enclosure for it and all of that. And that would be the total cost.
Does the current generator do anything for this part of the building?
Apparently, it does not provide electricity, but it will heat. And on the police stations, the other way around, no heater, air, just electricity. So we would use the police station in the event of an emergency disaster situation as the command central, and this would be available, well, first of all, to, you know, back up our computer and our information systems, but also as a potential small sheltering site if we needed to do that. I'm sorry.
Any reason it wasn't brought in front of the capital improvement planning committee?
I think it was a late entry in the game, and I don't know who was taking responsibility for that particular item, but it came across my radar, and I said, do you want to move this forward, so.
And I said, let's bring it up to the committee tonight.
So we have to go to this committee first.
Well, we can, do we want to ask the capital improvement committee to take a look at this?
Town bylaws require it.
Yep, or you just, or not. I guess that's basically what it amounts to. And so did either one of you involved in looking at?
No.
No?
What, looking at the generator?
Yeah, or looking at.
Well, I did with your son and your nephew. We looked at it, and I don't, what can I say? It's old and it's limited.
How many kW?
20? It was something fairly low.
20 kW is big.
Is that big? Okay, I don't know.
Well, 20 really is not that big.
That was what I.
It really isn't.
Does the price sound, do we need one? That's really.
Only when the power goes out, that's all.
So we only need one tonight, so hell with it.
So do we have a portable generator at the highway garage?
They have a generator. I don't think it's portable.
I don't know how portable it is.
Well, I don't.
They have a generator.
Do we have a generator?
I'm not sure. Do you know, John, is this a three-phase system?
I don't know. I do know, but I don't remember. I haven't worked on it in years.
I've never worked in here, so I don't know. Chance if it's a portable generator, you haven't got three-phase, but in material, I don't. I know this has been talked about for at least 5 years that I know of. And I'm not, by no means saying it's not needed, because you do have the PD here. You have all the town computers and everything else. However, there is a procedure, and I don't think that we should randomly bypass that procedure. It's unfortunate that it didn't get introduced, but I think it needs to go through capital just the way the bylaws say it, before it's brought to us.
The question is, do we want to ask capital to look at it, or is it too late in the game?
I think the town should ask the town to look at it, and if, and it's up to the capital to decide. I don't think we belong in the middle of this conversation.
I agree.
Well, I think we belong in it. It's getting late, so I think in that case, we could.
Well, can it go on a special town meeting?
Yeah, they're going to try to not put on capital items on special town meetings.
So it would be perhaps next.
So we can wait till next year.
I think what brought this up again, and, you know, I recall being here before, and I think vaguely recalling people talking about it when I was here several years ago. I think what happened in Conway is what brought this forward more recently. Geez, we should take a look at this again, and, you know, again, and take it seriously and move forward with replacing that. So if you ask why so late, that might have been the reason.
Maybe the Capital Improvement Planning Committee could meet and discuss it before it needs to.
How much money do we have left over from the budget?
Well, that's.
Is that all?
Yeah, I have to do a warrant tomorrow, so. We could also do it as a warrant article, but you'd still want to discuss it.
It's a bylaw.
I'm sorry?
The bylaws require.
Right.
It's going to happen. All right, so make your motion to ask them to do it, and I'll second.
Right.
So I'll move to ask the Capital Improvement Committee to take a look at this.
Second.
And if you don't want to look yet, then.
It's up to them.
To me? It's not up to me.
No, I was going to say the Capital Improvement Committee. If the Capital Improvement Committee thinks it's too late in the game, doesn't have enough time to really examine it, then fine.
When do we have to, what's the deadline? What's the?
Next week.
Pretty much.
Huh?
Well, the warrant, I'm hopefully, I have to have the board sign it tomorrow night, the warrant. But we've got, I'd like to get all the budget and the capital plan and.
Could you have it done tonight? You're a member over there.
Still not a quorum.
Within a week.
Not posted.
It's not posted.
How many you got in your committee?
Seven.
Oh, so you need one more.
Well.
When do you want to be on the committee?
Hard to get it posted, 48 hours, no.
Yeah, it's not, I mean, I can do it as soon as we can, but.
I'm sorry?
You wanted the.
I don't need it for tomorrow night. Tomorrow night is, you know, we don't have the budget. I mean, it's just, we're going to have our warrant articles.
Okay.
And then we've just got to work out all the detailed stuff on a few of them with, through the budget, capital plan and the budget.
You could put it on the warrant and just tell the people at the town meeting that it hasn't been seen by CIPC and let them decide.
We could pull it off.
Yeah, we can.
If it goes on as part of the capital article, then there's no details as she, for posting it. So really, the only details will be when you have the motion at that meeting, so.
Well, we have to approve the capital request?
No dollar amount.
Recommend, well, we have to recommend the capital.
Who's we? Finance?
Finance.
Yes, yes.
So would we add the 50 into it?
You don't have to have dollar amounts before.
Not for the CIPC.
We got a motion on the table, second to review.
Yes, we don't.
Second to ask Capital Improvement Committee to.
Yeah, for them to review it.
Okay, but I.
The timelines, I don't think allows.
I don't think we can do it.
Committee to do that. I mean, I'm not against entertaining it, you know, because it has been discussed. But I just think because of the timelines here that we're dealing with, that that's not a request that the Capital Improvement could fulfill just because of the time element.
I mean, I'm out of town Thursday.
And like I say, I'm not opposed to the, you know, the discussion that.
Well, it looks like we're probably going to have a special town meeting in fall.
Why don't we put it on the regular warrant and just tell the people in the town that the CIPC didn't have time to look at it? And here it is, people in the town. Do you want it?
No, I think it's complicated enough.
Most people don't know what a generator even does.
Yeah.
Okay.
So now.
We'll do it next time. Next year, next.
So do you want to withdraw your motion, or?
The one we have is still working, right?
We think that it will do this here and that there, but not both here and there, the heat and the electricity in both sections of the building. We think. I don't know when it's been tested. I don't know what, you know, if that's theory or practice, you know, if that...
It hardly takes care of anything that I do know exactly what. And I agree with you totally. I just think it's very unfortunate that it never got brought up before, but I just...
So let's put it into the works for next year someplace, whether it's a special town meeting or preferably the annual town meeting.
Do you want to...
I will withdraw my motion if you withdraw your second.
Already did it.
Can somebody put the capital request in the mailbox for CIPC and then we can vote on it? Even if it's not in time for the meeting, but it will have been voted.
Yeah, if you vote before April 24th.
Do you want a motion on the capital request?
Yeah, let's do that.
Make a motion that we approve capital request for $49,500.
It's moved. Is there a second for capital?
I'll second it.
Moved and seconded. Is there any more discussion?
Yeah, just out of curiosity, I'm not sure. What's the flooring, are they replacing, where's that?
In the elementary school.
In the school.
All of that's the elementary school.
Oh, this is all the elementary school?
All the italicized.
You were happy with all that stuff, John?
Yeah, we approved it all.
Yes.
Okay.
Some time ago.
All right.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? 7-0. Okay, S2. Let's do capital stabilization next. So we've talked about capital stabilization, and now that we're at a point where we have a good handle on, and we will talk about this shortly. I suppose we could, if somebody really wants to know what the numbers are, maybe we can throw those out. What are we looking at?
I'd rather go through the budget first, if we could. Before we take these last two items, we voted against, we definitely want capital state. We've already voted against OPEB.
Yeah. Selectmen asked if we'd take it up.
I understand.
Before we go to the budget, look at that. Skip, did you want to relook at the planning board first, the small one?
Do I have it here?
We don't have it.
It's I didn't reprint it. It's nothing has changed as far as John's request, but Skip was wondering if
reconsider.
If we should reconsider and revote that one.
I'll revote it.
I'll
make a motion because I've made a motion.
It's in your tab 3, and I think it is. Oh, let's see. I don't know if it has the number on it, but it's one of the last ones in your tab 3. It should be 175-5400 between open space and zoning board.
75-5400.
So currently, I made a motion. To reduce it to a dollar three or four meetings ago. I'll make a motion tonight to increase it to $1,000.
How much was it initially?
$6,000. That's one of those where they have. At least recently, they haven't
23,000 in reserves, revolving fund.
Yeah.
Why not use the revolving fund money? That's what I don't understand.
It's limited. You can't use it for all their expenses.
I mean, that was the initial thought when we voted a dollar. That was my thought anyway.
I would feel more comfortable with $1,000, and I think we send a message and without being.
Yeah, I understand. It was off the cuff.
Yeah,
it was off the cuff. I mean, if we give the energy committee $1,000.
The revolving, though, is used just for specific, not for anything,
I think it has to relate to what you're taking, what the income is that's coming in, and their, the revolving fund has income in there from ANRs and other applications. So what are the appropriate expenses against that? I guess I don't know, but.
Well, it's at $25,000 is the limit of the revolving fund. That was what was voted at town meeting.
Yeah, so anything over that.
Anything over that, it's called a free cash. General fund?
I think if they were in danger of going over that, I think we'd have to, I don't even know what, I've never experienced that. So I don't know if they have to go to town meeting for a new vote on that, or if they have to come out another source.
Actually, the new Mass Municipal Act of the 53E allows for after, assuming that it's been approved at town meeting, at any point after, Selectmen and Finance Committee can raise that limit.
Yes, thank you very much.
Just a refresher.
Yeah.
I know you've got a ton of things on your mind, but.
So if they receive monies for fees, for A&R subdivision plans, those type of things, it would seem as though they could use it to hire consultants to review subdivision plan, maybe for town lawyer.
I believe they do.
Like, well, they have.
I think there was some money that came out of there for FERCOG at one point.
FERCOG for zoning, so that.
I'm not sure what.
Well, we pay, you know, for Pat Smith's services.
That's.
But I, that's somewhere else, I think, because that's about $15,000 to $25,000 a year.
That's part of the services we hire on. FERCOG, we get Pat for so many hours at the planning board, but she does submit individual quotes for certain reviews.
And that can come out of the fees that they get.
That would be my feeling.
Yeah, that is, that's what it does, the 50.
Because they've only spent $83.
Three and a half, whatever that is.
And the use of the fund, the way it was designated is activities and expenses related to proposal and permit reviews.
Yeah.
Is the way it's, was written, so.
So I got a motion on table for $1,000.
Yeah, and if they can use that fund, let them use the revolving fund.
And we're getting a message across it.
Okay.
And they do generally use the revolving fund first before they use the regular appropriation.
Okay, all of those in favor of changing the recommendation on the planning board to $1,000?
Aye.
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 Opposed? So 7-0. Capital stabilization. Do you want to, let's take a look at the financial situation, the town, or the budget's financial position. I think you all have two or three pages.
Four. Three.
Three or four pages, four or five pages.
Three.
Which one do you want to go over first?
Well, I think.
Can I take a look at the tax levy calculation?
Yeah, I was thinking the tax levy calculation. If I know I printed this earlier for you in the year, but we did not have the number for the debt reduction on the school at that point. So you have the levy limit from last year carried over at the $10,037,006, and then the 2.5%. Added on to that, and then new growth. Generally, new growth has been much more than the 50,000, as you can see from the past 4 years. But the assessors are uncomfortable with us budgeting anything higher than 50,000, not knowing really what fiscal 18 is going to shape up to be like. So we've threw in 50,000 there for you to at least have something in there to go by. And then you'll see on the lower section, the debt exclusion of the $490,272 is really made up of just the garage bond and the school roof loan. In your lower section of your report, there's a little synopsis of that.
Excuse me, didn't we just, I don't remember, did that include the Oxford loan too?
No. The Oxford loan is not debt.
Oh, that's not debt, right, that's debt, okay, sorry.
So So we've got our maximum allowable levy of $10,828,203, which is a 4.05% increase.
So that debt exclusion includes the principal and the interest?
Yes.
If we take the two numbers and add them together, we'll get that.
So the $100,000 becomes $118,000. Maturing debt, we had $100,000 for the school roof, and now we have $118,000.
The 18 is.
The 18,750 is the interest.
That's okay, yeah.
What's the interest account, you know, off the top of your head?
$751,5900.
Okay, what's?
We revoted that one, I think, last week, the week before, with the actual figure that we got on the loan.
So that brings us over to this page here that has revenue detail on it. And $10,000, or $10,828,203, is at the top of the page under property tax. After that, it's a breakdown of the state cherry sheet revenues anticipated, and this is anticipated. This is the governor's proposal.
When we get to the fall and we do our recap, we'll have to go with the final numbers, but right now, this is the governor's proposal.
Well, we'll get some other numbers between now and town. We may get other numbers. So the two that are out there or will come in is the House, their recommendation, followed by the Senate, and then whatever the
Conference committee
after that. So. And the one thing you don't see there is the school choice, incoming school choice.
Yes, because that is not a general fund item. Yes, John?
Whoops. The interest in the maturing debt and the maturing debt on the garage, that's up to...
You're right. It's a difference of $8,228.
Something like that, yeah.
Which is the amortization of the bond premium that we have to take every year.
Okay. And that's in the interest. All right.
Yeah, sorry about that. That is
you know what that is?
That's all right.
Do you know what that is?
Yeah.
Okay. Everybody know what the bond premium is?
No, I don't. Well,
explain it if you want.
I have an idea, but
I don't know if I can explain it. It's a premium based on do you know how to explain that to me?
I don't
know.
Bob's
here. We can. She knows.
But we received a premium when we took out the bond for the garage. We received a premium of about $147,000. Oh, yeah, Mary.
Well, it's the premium at the time, then you have to take it off every year, right? Well,
yes.
Yeah.
So they actually pay us to take the bond out, which makes no sense
exactly.
At all.
Yeah.
So when we got that money in, we applied a portion of that, or we paid the financing costs out of that first, and then what's left has to be amortized over the life of the loan, which is 20 years.
And we have an amortization schedule that we follow?
We do.
Go ahead.
Sorry.
No, it's quite all right.
Do you want me to continue, Skip?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. No, absolutely.
So we've just thrown in a figure of overlay of about $120,000. That's kind of an average of what the assessors have done in the past. Really what it boils down to is they make that decision at the very end, right before we finish the recap. So that's just an estimate. And then the local receipts. These are all numbers that we went through earlier in the fall as a committee.
Mm-hmm. And these are estimates.
Yep.
Conservative estimates. Then go to your backside of that sheet. So we have other funding sources, and really there you go. There's your $8,228 from the receipts reserved for debt, which is the bond premium amortization. And then the next three line items are the indirect costs for South County EMS, the wastewater treatment plant, and for the senior center. So really at this point, that's all we've considered for other funding sources.
And we keep trying to get the assessors to give us overlay surplus.
Right, we have, Wendy put in a request to...
I sent a memo to the assessors.
Asking if they would give up $100,000 for purposes of helping to fund the budget.
To reduce our free cash reliance.
So then, the other thing we have in here for other accounts is the Dickinson Library Trust. That's interest from the Dickinson Library Trust that gets allocated to the school and to the library every year. And then you see here the sewer revenue that will correspond directly with your sewer expenses on your other budget sheet. So that brings us down to free cash.
But sewer revenue's in a, it's in its own entity, right? Doesn't, it's not part, well, it's part of the, it's a warrant article, right?
Yes.
It's an article, correct.
Okay.
And since we have the articles on the detail of the expenses, then we bring it in as income.
Understood.
So that brings us to free cash. We started with $1,585,000. We are using $926,000 of that, if you so approve of the $200,000 for capital stabilization. So that does include the capital stabilization figure, as presented to you, that you'll go over here in a few minutes. So that leaves us with $658,974 in free cash, and that's after the omnibus budget and all the special articles at this point.
That's good, that's almost 5% of a $13 million budget.
It is, 4.23%.
And our policy is to keep 5%, so we're right on target.
That's good.
Because last year, I think we had to drop it to $300,000, or three-something.
Yeah, it was close, it was much closer.
Yes.
So, on the expenditure side, the budget side...
Those are your nice colored sheets.
Yeah, Brenda is, we're using them for the purposes of trying to figure out how much free cash. We're using the requested figure as opposed to the recommended figure.
Yes.
Which one? Say that again, Skip, please.
We're using the requested amounts as opposed to the recommended amounts.
Just for purposes of looking at this.
Be conservative.
Partly because we didn't have, we hadn't gone through all of these items and recommended them or not yet.
So if anything is less, then we'll have more free cash.
Correct, yeah.
If we get supported by the town.
Well, they can't raise anything on the town meeting floor. You mean the select board?
They can't go over the requested amount.
No.
Or the recommended.
No.
Whichever's higher.
Oh, really?
Right.
The town meeting cannot.
No, you wonder.
Town meeting cannot. They can reduce, but they cannot increase.
The higher the two, they can't go over it. They can't raise it.
Well, it depends how we present it.
Legally, they can, but what happens is, the introductory motion that's brought up by the moderator says that they cannot do it, and we vote that, which makes it effective for that night.
Got it.
Technically, they can.
Well, certain percentage.
I just want to make sure everybody's on.
No, I appreciate that. I didn't know that, I appreciate that. Again, I'm the newbie.
That's the way Deerfield does it.
I realize it took us several years to figure that out.
I can.
So I give away the secrets so fast.
The mic's working, well, tell me, Skip.
On your detail sheets, page four, I just want to note one item here.
Which report?
Page four.
Page four of your detail expense.
Looks like this. It's got the schools on it, the...
So if you look at the warrant articles, there is one item here that doesn't have a budget sheet that goes with it, it never has, I don't know why not, but it's for the Smith folk out of district placement.
Yep.
We had a placeholder in there last year, and we put in $32,000. We've spent very little of that this year for one student, but we just, Wendy, I visited with Wendy about it, and we put in just a small amount in case we have a student next year. We've been told there is no student for next year.
But we don't know.
But just in case we have one, we've got money in the budget. It might not be enough to cover all of it, but at least it's there, and we can always draw from the reserve fund for any additional costs.
It'll get us through September.
What's that?
It'll get us through September.
Yeah.
And if there's still an October.
The end of September.
What number is that? I don't see it.
It's, there's not a number. It's just under warrant articles.
It's on the bottom of the.
And it's actually in the.
There are two numbers.
Well, it is.
Lettering is in black.
It's like five.
Chapter 74.
Chapter 74, Smith Volk tuition and Smith Volk transportation.
Right.
On page four.
So we actually need to vote those two, I guess.
Do you? Okay, I didn't know how.
Yeah, just to.
There you go.
Where's, I don't have an article for transportation. We combine it in the article.
Yeah.
You put $10,000 in it.
It's just one article for two.
Voted as one item.
Right.
Yeah.
So you want a motion on that?
Sure.
Make a motion to approve $10,000 for chapter 22, correction, article 22, chapter 74, Smith vocational tuition and transportation as required.
It's moved, seconded?
For $10,000.
Seconded.
The five and five. See the five and five?
Oh, yeah, okay.
Any further questions on this one? Does anybody see it? Does everyone see that? If there are no further questions, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? 7-0. Okay. So now, let's just so that, does anybody have any questions on the 100 series general government?
Page one.
Yeah, page one, and it flips over slightly to page two. I mean, these are all figures that we've.
Already approved them, like they should be.
Okay.
What about PIG access capital is not on here yet, right?
Yeah, we can put it in.
Voted it yet.
But we could add it in here.
Also, the planning board will have to make the change from a dollar to a thousand.
Yes.
And the energy committee also.
Yeah.
So.
Assessors.
Yeah, I'll get all those changes made and print out the reports for your next.
Okay.
But the PIG access capital, that's going to have $50,000 expenses, but then you'll also have to add it to revenue detail, right?
No, the revenue has already been received, so it'll be in free cash starting July 1st.
I guess one I'm still a little concerned is the legal expense. It seems like that is.
I'm lost. Increase expense is $50,000. Oh, but we're using requested. Never mind.
Okay.
But that's in free cash now?
It will be at the end of this fiscal year because we just received it like, I don't know, a couple months ago.
So we won't be able to spend it until free cash is certified.
Right.
Technically.
Well, unless we take it.
I mean, we're voting it into the omnibus budget starting July 1st.
We are taking this out of the existing free cash.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Basically, yes.
All right. It was legal expenses?
Yeah, that's been continually underfunded every year.
Yes.
I thought we bumped it up.
We did this year because of the Montague.
No, I thought the select board actually bumped it up to 30-something.
Oh, okay.
In there. Were you not at that meeting where we discussed it? The board plans to bump it up till, I believe, 30,000.
It's a little late.
Yeah, really.
$23,700.
Yeah.
And it's been every year. It's been in the 30s, and every year that I can remember ends up going into reserves to fund it.
Yes.
We voted this 214, so.
Right.
Right. Asked if we had any questions, so.
Well, sorry for the misstep in communication there, but when the board discussed the budgets are under our purview, that we should have let you know that we did that, that they did that.
Request assessed $23,700. How much is it going up?
They looked at the past, and they thought that $30,000 was a safer number to go with.
$30,000.
My recollection now, I'm recalling that.
Oh, since this was done?
Well, it was a few weeks ago, so. Yeah, since you did it. You talked about it a long time ago, after you did. I think you were in that room having the meeting while we were doing that.
So do you want a motion to increase our recommendation to $30,000?
How about if we vote to increase the requested amount to $30,000 and then?
And then do we want to recommend it from finance?
Recommend $30,000. Yeah, that's, that's fine. You want to make that motion?
And leave ours the same at the $23,700?
No.
No. So move.
Well, it's $151,300?
$151,5300.
$53,000.
Well, in legal expense.
Can I hear the motion again?
So first thing we're doing is to change the requested amount to $30,000.
All over the place.
That's the left column.
We'll work on that.
And don't ask me where that other $6,300 is going to, but someplace.
You don't have to worry, they'll spend it.
Adjustment. $6,300. Okay.
Don't you call that?
So we're not going to change.
Error correction?
Error correction.
So we're not changing our recommendation, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Then we're voting to, then the request or the motion was to change our voted amount to $30,000.
So increasing our motion by the 30.
How much are we spending so far?
So move twice.
I don't know.
Was there a second twice?
I think we've spent $23,000 or so far.
Anytime nobody seconds it, you automatically do it.
I'll second it.
Include the last bill, which I just.
So the motion, there's two motions on the floor?
Want to do two motions? Let's do two motions.
I'm just asking, I don't know.
No, let's do two motions.
Figure out what's going on.
The first motion.
He said he wanted to change requested, the left column, up to $30,000. So that was the first motion.
That would be, that would be what we need to do.
That's what we're telling the selectmen what we're going to give them.
We've already approved what's on the sheet.
$23,700.
So it would just be one motion to increase it, wouldn't it? But we've done that in the past all along.
Well, you just went back and revoted some things that you would approve.
Yeah, we just did that.
Increase it to $30,000.
With the planning board, we increased our voted amount, our recommended amount. In this case.
We're doing it for a selectman.
We're taking the selectmen's, and we're saying, all right, we're going to increase the requested amount to $30,000. And that's, if that's acceptable to us. So, yeah, it's $30,000.
Yeah, okay.
All those in favor of the changing the requested amount to $30,000?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. And then the second vote was to recommend.
By the finance committee.
Finance committee recommendation, $30,000.
Why is it going up?
Because they spent too much money on legal.
Do you need that seconded?
Yeah.
Seconded.
Take a look at what they spent over the years.
It's, yeah.
$46,000, $32,000, $34,000, $29,000, $31,000.
Appropriate.
John, then they come back for the reserve fund after, later in the year.
Every year.
Right, and that hits the reserve fund that we have on hand.
Every year they've been doing it.
I have to say, this happens in most towns, actually, with legal.
Right, okay, well, we can be.
Proactive.
Proactive.
Right, it would be better to know.
So we got a second motion? Ever vote on that?
Yes.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? So that's unanimous also.
Yeah.
We're going to need another transfer, too.
No, it's too late. They can't get any transfers. Stop spending money.
We have so much going on.
That's going to come right out of the free cash that you're calculating, right, available, that will be withheld.
Yes, oh, absolutely. Okay. Let's, before we spend any more money, let's go on to public safety.
I have a question.
Do we have a separate one?
Non-public. So police, there's an article on the warrant for $35,000.
It's gone down to $22,500.
Whatever it is.
Okay.
What is that?
There's an article to.
For the police contract.
For the police contract for, was at $30,000, whatever it was.
$35,000.
$35,000. Now it's $23,000?
$22,500, I think.
So the cost of the new contract was just signed well after we had approved the budget last year. Is costing John about $35,000. He's been able to use the school resource officer revolving fund to cover some of those expenses, and I'm trying to remember what else. But he felt that a more reasonable figure to ask for this year.
So when did we sign the contract with the police?
Like in September, August or September?
Yes, I think about then, because I remember when I was...
Became retroactive?
It was retroactive.
Retro to July 1st.
So we were short $35,000 pretty much.
Yeah, we actually had this on your...
That's a major increase.
Special town meeting, we knew, but that didn't happen.
And now they're getting another increase of at least that for nine more people, for the same nine this year?
Just a step increase for those offices.
From 5%?
I don't know if it is. Is that a 5% increase?
That's a police contract, so whatever the police contract is, which is separate from the town.
Right.
Right.
Because the salaries, as I recall, were up $50,000 on the budget.
So they would have included the...
No.
Third, well...
No, this is not addition.
This is an addition, so we're looking for $85,000 or...
Well, but the current year's, we're looking for $35,000 in the current year.
Yeah.
And that would carry forward to next year.
$35,000 plus $15,000 more.
Plus $15,000 more.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is probably the step increase.
That's what I'm guessing.
I guess the question is, where is that? That's a warrant item?
Yes.
Warrant article?
Yes.
Yep.
To take out of free cash, right?
Well, it doesn't say.
Yeah, we don't know, you know.
That will go at town meeting.
You're right, and that probably should be on.
That should be on here.
So we probably ought to put that, we ought probably...
We'll review the articles. We got to talk. I don't have that many.
So it might be taking more or less free cash to balance this budget.
What's that?
We might be taking more or less free cash to balance this budget.
So far, we're taking more.
I know.
Well, yeah, I don't think anybody's giving back.
So basically $30,000 more.
Or whatever.
Plus the...
I mean, the other way that we...
Legal, plus the legal.
That's what I included, yeah.
The other way we could handle it is to use the reserve.
And whether you can, did you put the OPEB?
Yeah.
I don't think you're going to have enough in the reserve.
That was through negotiations, correct, in the bargaining agreement?
Yes, yes.
And that's not within our control or the town's control per se, correct? Because that was a negotiated item?
Well, it is in the town's, it's not, it's nothing that we have any control.
That's what I'm saying.
I mean, we can say no, and it doesn't mean it's going to get paid.
Right.
So the question is, do we want to put it as a warrant item, or do we want to use the reserve fund?
We only have $54,000 in the reserve fund now, and I know there are a couple of requests or some things out there that we need to take care of.
I think we should put it in the separate article.
And it's transparent this way, too.
Yep. Okay, so add that into this thing someplace.
So the entire shortfall of the police department would be this warrant article?
Just for that contract.
And they don't have, and when they end up at the end of the year, they anticipate to have zero balance.
Correct.
Maybe. They typically...
I'm sure there's a little cushion in there.
There's usually some.
Yeah, needs to be.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so we have, that's, what else do we have next?
Capital stabilization and then OPEB, I think we're...
Well, it's going to take, well...
I have a question.
Oh, you want to keep going through that?
Yeah. Any other questions on public safety?
There's skims and Public safety?
No, that's on warrant articles.
All right. No.
Okay, education? There is no frontier capital, right?
Right.
Not that I'm aware of.
The school committee voted, did not vote to.
The roof project is in our general fund budget.
But Frontier did not vote to go forward with their roof project.
Oh, that one.
The ban?
Okay.
The other roof.
Yeah, the ban, I see. She was talking about Frontier.
Yeah.
So how does that work?
Forgot there's two roofs.
What's that?
How does that ban work when they approve money?
The bound anticipation note?
That's just borrow.
Right.
Just allowed to borrow it, and then we won't probably see the first payment till next year, maybe year after next?
On the Deerfield roof? We put the $100,000.
Frontier.
Oh, Frontier? We don't know.
No, this is the elementary school.
Oh, I thought they did something in Frontier.
They did chose, they didn't, it didn't. We expected something, but it didn't happen. The media center is not moving forward at this point.
Okay, sorry, misunderstood.
Even if it does, they, you know, they wouldn't have any sufficient detail to the budget.
Well, they paid $6,000 for somebody to come up with an estimate.
I thought they were talking around $320,000.
The message I got from the superintendent was that the school committee did not vote to proceed at this time.
All right, let's see. So, public safety, education. The next one is page three, public works.
Snow and ice, you have to.
And the selectmen do want to, human services?
No.
Yeah, we have another, it's free cash, yeah.
Pardon?
Warrant article, the snow and ice.
Is that 14? 14, and the bridge?
There's a whole bunch of.
No, we're getting rid of.
Articles.
I know.
Budgets in there.
Yeah.
Which we don't know. Well, we'll have to later.
I have to add the snow and ice.
I guess another question would be, as far as the salary items, where are those based on? Old schedule, new schedule?
New schedule.
New schedule.
New schedule.
All the salary items in the budget are based on the new schedule.
Okay.
And the way that's set up, the vote is voted for 1 year?
No, it's not.
Look at it next year?
Well, we'll talk about it tonight.
The warrant article doesn't say that.
We'll have a discussion on the salary schedule tonight. Human services? Selectmen want their mosquito money, just to let you know.
All right, let the town people vote on it.
Yeah, let the town vote, yep. That's my opinion, anyway.
Mine, too.
Does this include the, yeah, the request?
Request, yes.
Yep.
And culture and recreation?
So actually.
The summer swim program.
We just revoted that.
Right, we just revoted. So you recommended a 4?
Yes.
Debt service?
That's the one we just revoted for the.
Yeah.
Intergovernmental and benefits? warrant articles voted separately.
Yeah, what happened Monday night with the EMS director's salary?
Personnel board?
Yeah, that's...
What?
EMS director's salary.
EMS director's salary, Monday night, you had a meeting?
We had a meeting Monday night.
That, no, okay.
And what happened?
My understanding, correct me if I'm wrong, do you want to speak to it, or...
No, be my guest.
Please correct me if I'm wrong.
You're wrong.
Secondhand information, that the recommendation was to, fund isn't right, but award the requested amount for retro for the previous request salary.
For the FY '17.
Right, and that is 66, something like that?
65.
70,000.
70 versus 66.
Wait, wait.
I went to 70.
Going to 69, I think. I don't have my paper.
I thought it was 66. Okay, we got to get that straight. I wasn't there. Again, I have secondhand information. And then to ask for before FY '18, see a evaluation and another request. Is that correct?
Yes.
Before doing any, taking any action on that request. So they're just talking about...
Right. The original request was to put him to 75,000, and we couldn't justify bringing him up. He's gone up.
Yep.
When he started, they knew that he had a learning curve, so they went to step one. Then they put him to step four when they thought he had progressed, okay? And then the following year, he just got a step, I believe. I should have brought my notes tonight. But they want to bring him up to 75,000.
Is that part of the, is that in our...
Is that part of our schedule?
Part of our schedule?
Yeah, definitely.
69 something is part of our...
69 is part of our schedule.
So step...
So he'll go from 66 to 69. And then in fiscal '18, they will... That is basically two steps on our schedule.
I know. How you doing?
I'd like to know what the compensation is in some other town for a director of a three ambulance service. How does that, what we're budgeting compared to that?
The problem is with that department, they have a giveaway mentality. Just give, 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 don't worry about it, because they've always had hundreds of thousands of dollars extra in the budget. And I know some people don't like me saying that, but that's a fact. If you took a look at what they got for year one, $502,000 extra out of $1.1 million budget, and another half million the second year, that means you could buy three brand-new ambulances in 2 years. That's so far overfunded and so inflated, it's bigger than that big mattress they have on TV where it's puffed up for $2,399 instead of $570. That's how ridiculous it is.
Get one of those.
The personnel board really felt very strongly that they should be on, we should be on the schedule. And that we have been defeated many times over about people being hired steps above where they... I mean, we don't have, we have his job description, but we've never actually, you know, numbered it out according to the... The process, yes. We asked several questions about exactly what he does, and we felt as a board that he should not be, going up to where they want.
That's fine, I don't just, I was just curious. But when we approved the salaries, we approved $252,665.
You're right, I realized I was off a dollar, it's the rounding.
Then there's a $500 deduction, so it's recommended.
What you talking?
That was something I missed today in updating it, but you had, approved it at the $252,665.
So there's no $500?
No, no.
And that's, okay.
Nope, I saw that too tonight and realized that didn't get changed.
So what was that, that for, are we talking skims?
Yes, skim salaries, we approved at $252,665.
Actually, that's the wastewater treatment.
Oh, excuse me.
Yeah, okay.
I'm sorry. Skims.
Yeah, South Carolina wastewater is just the entire budget.
I'm sorry, wastewater treatment, yeah.
Skim salary.
That was different. I was looking at the other one.
$267,117.
Yeah, wastewater salary.
So South County EMS, I think everybody probably is aware of it, maybe not, but at the meeting last, is it last Wednesday? We did, the recommendation from the Oversight Committee was to take whatever funds were left in the enterprise and in the retained earnings and use those in the budget, either to lower the budget or to purchase something else. So this number here of $267,117 does that.
So what happened to the move-in expenses and?
It's in the budget, whatever's in the budget.
So this is the balance of the retained earnings?
No. The retained earnings have been used.
They're all but $50,000.
$54,000.
$54,000.
And they had $100,000 in reserve.
And the $100,000 reserve, so what are you saying, the balance, everything but that?
Well, even the $100,000 is used, it's part of their operating budget.
I understand.
Yep. So they're using it to reduce, essentially they're using it.
Assessments.
Well, it's not to reduce their budget, but it's sitting in there anyways.
Right.
So it can be spent.
Without approval.
Without coming back, without town meeting, town meeting approves it this way.
What they said at joint meeting, they come to us.
Yes, they do have to come to the Finance Committee to.
Spend any of the $100,000.
It's just like the reserve fund transfer.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not sure, they still have $54,000 retained earnings, which is carried forth. Right, is that correct?
Yes.
And, but that's.
Well, they've designated it though.
Well, we took it out.
Yeah.
We took it out.
We did, but what about them?
Well, they'll have to come back to you for approval.
We're not the, are we the controlling factor?
We're the fiscal agent.
We're the fiscal agent.
Oh, you mean the town?
We told them to put it back in retained earnings, not put it in their capital line item.
Because we don't know if it's.
We actually recommended basically that they put the $100,000 back in retained earnings also, but chose to leave it in.
Right, that's correct.
Which means that.
It goes away at the end of the year.
At the end of the year, it goes back into retained earnings.
Yep.
And it won't be available.
So they have to budget it every year.
Well, that's if they, but only if they have $100,000 in their retained earnings at the end of this year can they budget it.
Right.
Not sure that they know what the impact of that is.
So that all but that $100,000, which is already in the budget, plus the $54,000 has been utilized to reduce the assessments. Is that what you were saying?
Or, yeah, or to, for capital items.
Yes.
The ambulance.
The ambulance and stretchers and infusion pumps.
Mm-hmm. All right, any other questions on this?
Yeah, could I step back one notch?
For the one, I'm going to need the.
One faster than me. Back to Tilton Library.
Yep.
They have a state a library state aid fund that has a balance of $19,637. What is that fund and why is it not being used?
I'm sorry, we were talking about something.
Library state fund, Fund 414.
That is being used, that's where the monies go from the state.
Yeah.
For support of the library, and Sarah does use that for the things that she can use it for.
So is it very restricted as to what they?
Yep.
I would assume so, I don't know the details.
So.
But it comes directly to them and then as they use it.
Yes.
So that can't be used for any of the items that are in the tilt?
Well, like, I don't know what you're getting at, because the state requires them to put so much money in, or they won't get the state aid.
Right.
Yeah.
But they have a state aid.
But they have a state aid fund that won't be fully expended at the end of the year.
Right.
Potentially. What happens to that money?
It, as of June 30 last year, they.
Carries over.
Yeah, so, I mean, they've used like $4,000 out of it, so that's what I just.
So in other words, okay, yeah, so we voted so much so they could get that, so.
Right, if their budget isn't an increase.
Right, their budget has to be a minimum amount in order for them to get their state aid.
Right, then their state aid, they can use it for whatever it's designated, and they can carry it over for the rest of, whenever they want to use it.
So, okay.
But they get state aid every year. That was on the cherry sheet.
Yes.
I don't know, I can't remember what they're getting.
You still have 2 minutes. Is that what you wanted to do?
Nobody came in to register, everyone's registered.
Why, you want to book the register to vote?
Want to unregister?
We're going to talk about OPEB?
If we're finished with this, yes.
Okay. Come on, though.
Oh, that's, we're going to talk about OPEB.
Actually,
come on down.
Join us for 2 minutes and you and John have it out.
Huh?
Barb and you can talk.
About what?
OPEB.
Oh.
We're back.
Why we should put.
Post-employment benefits.
Other people's money. Other people's something or other benefits.
Other people expense something?
Revisiting the.
Extended benefits.
As they had voted not to.
So the selectmen asked if we would please take another look at this. So I said sure.
So this stuff is for $10,000.
$10,000, okay.
Explain why you feel that we should have this account.
Well, I just think that it reflects sound financial planning on our part. Whether it's an aggressive policy or amount or not, at least it's an acknowledgement, and it looks like financial agencies like, you know, bond council, that kind of thing, would look upon it in a positive nature. If we had a policy where we said we're going to put a little away every year, even if it's a marginal amount, for something that we know is an outstanding liability. So what I had suggested is that we do something that we can do every year, something that's doable. In other words, we can make a policy to say that it's our policy, we're going to put away $10,000 every year or $20,000 every year. And that's what they're looking for, rather than a vote each year, whereas you could say no 1 year and yes 1 year. They're looking for more of a policy where you're going to support it each and every year, and this is what you're going to do. And if you end up building on it, then great, but at least you have something. And I suggested, I think originally I suggested 20,000 or 10, something like that, because you can spend out of the OPEB for retiree expenses. So I thought if there were a year where we were extremely tight on the budget and we had the 10 or 20,000 going into the account, we could also expense out, which is about the same amount, our retiree group insurance costs. So, I mean, we would net zero if it was a really bad fiscal year. So anyway, that's kind of the thought behind the amount and the policy and the. Yeah, I mean, it's clearly moving in that direction, whereas the GASB 45, they started saying that we had to identify what our outstanding liabilities would be. And then they moved into GASB 65 and 75 and 74, and they're moving it from the notes section of our financials up to the front page, if you will. Not to say that bond council couldn't find it in our notes or whatever, but it's becoming more of a prominent statement on our financials. Do I think we should put away $100,000 every year or something aggressive like that? No, I don't see an atmosphere where all of a sudden all of our retirees would be, you know, retired and taking all full benefits and the extent that our, you know, OPEB and our GASB 45 reports. Those are huge numbers. So I just thought maybe it was something we could do.
Is the OPEB just health insurance?
It is, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's any post-employment benefits, but the only thing that we have for post-employment benefits is health insurance.
They're already doing retirement.
Right. Mm-hmm, yeah. And we can use it, so it's sort of be treated like a reserve. Right?
You can use it only for retiree group insurance.
Right, but so, but we could spend it.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. So okay. if we're putting away, you know, this kind of smaller amount, things were really bad.
Do you know offhand what the retiree health insurance benefits are annually?
Well, I think right now I did it up and it was like 13 or 14,000. That's kind of how I came up with this, you know. I think originally I'd said 20,000. That's okay. I thought if we did 20,000 that was a, you know, that was something. Mm-hmm. Not huge, and going forward it would probably be equal to what our retirees insurance would
be. I think originally everyone thought it was just putting money away and we weren't going to be able to do anything with it.
Yeah.
So, yeah. And I know this is what you told me before, that we can use it against mm-hmm. that. So you're not really putting money away that's going to stay there forever, or mm-hmm. could right. stay there forever. But
yeah, it is clearly earmarked for that only. So if all of a sudden, you know, I wouldn't want to say that we put $100,000 and get this huge nest egg and then our, you know, town hall burns down and we have all this money and we can't use it. So that's why I thought maybe a little bit would at least be something that we can do, and then we can see what happens and maybe we end up wanting to do more or not.
Can the auditor suggest that also?
Yeah, I think everyone's, yeah, kind of marginal on the amount, but yeah, I think it's a good idea to put away something.
Is there going to be, once this fund starts being contributed to, is there going to be annual actuarial cost involved to this still? Or?
Well, we have to do an actuary every 3 years anyway.
Yeah. We already are.
We've done it twice
what
now.
What was the last one? I don't remember, but it was outrageous in any of that.
No, it's like, yeah, millions, like, I don't know.
2+ million.
Yeah. So...
But we established a policy, I think, last year when we talked about it. And the policy was that we're going to wait until 2033 when all the retirement thing was paid up to date. And then we'd mm-hmm. have extra money instead of sending it into the retirement system that we could start contributing more heavily. Now, that was our policy last year. Mm-hmm. If we put in $10,000 this year, the policy is not going to be $10,000 every year. This is going to be a one-time payment of $10,000. And if we have money next year, then we'll put it in again.
Okay. I don't think that's really what they're looking for as far as a policy. Yeah. So
well,
I'm just passing
along.
Well,
we already said a policy last year would be that mm-hmm. we'd wait to 2033 when retirement funding got fully funded. And once that became fully funded mm-hmm. at that time, we would start putting in for OPEB.
Yeah.
That was
well,
our
that
policy
would,
before.
That would certainly be an opportunity to be more aggressive if that's what it looked
well,
like was
I think
necessary.
This is very aggressive with $10,000.
Yeah. Okay.
And I don't have a problem with $10,000 now. Mm-hmm. Before, when it came up, I was totally against the $20,000 mm-hmm. because I know when Charlie Baker got voted into office, he says that they don't know what they're doing, they don't know what they're going to recommend, mm-hmm. they're going to get back to us, and they never did it.
Well,
now, I know that what the COG did because I was up there, mm-hmm. and the COG agreed because they had $100,000+ left over in free cash that they'd put it into OPEB funding,
right.
which is fine. We don't have that kind of money normally.
Mm-hmm.
This year, I feel comfortable. I can live with $10,000. Mm-hmm. To jump it up to 20, that's another issue.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Bless you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Any further questions?
Do you want a motion?
Sure.
Make a motion that we approve OPEB funding for $10,000.
I'll second.
Moved, seconded. Any further discussion?
Yeah, I'd just like to say I'm against the GASB 45.
That's okay, you can say it.
But with it, because I think it's ridiculous, because it never will really have to be paid at once, all at once, kind of, all at once. But since it's there, and it does affect the bond rating, we can use it if we need to. I'll say aye.
It's a different reflection.
I'll just say that the idea of funding employment benefits for those employees who have retired, I understand the purpose of doing that. Since they've already worked here, when they leave, then the town should not have an obligation to pay anything. That should have been taken care of. And that's basically what the what they've required of the private sector. My problem, and I don't know whether it's where we agree or not, but is that the numbers that I saw just made no sense, nor could I get an answer from the presentation, which was back in 2013, as to how anybody arrived at those numbers, and it was so.
Let me tell you how they did it. They took everybody who's working for the town, assumed they're going to work there. They were 65, counted the number of years, figured out actuarially cost increases for every one of them, and that's for every employee. Now, what happens if somebody leaves early? There's no credit on that, because nobody's ever going to leave early. That's what they say. So what happens is...
Not with our salary schedule.
Whatever, hang out.
Very good.
Whatever you have for a maximum benefit on there, it'll be that or something less. So we don't know the true figure.
Well, the thing is, we do have an idea when it comes to health insurance.
Right.
I mean, we don't know exactly, but...
We don't know when health insurance is going to go up.
Well,
it was a couple of years it was flat, now it just jumped up.
But you do know, because at 65, 99% of the people taking health insurance are going to be a Medicare.
Right.
And that's a number that we do have. So this doesn't seem to jive with Medicare. That's
a question.
Yeah.
But we are paying now for our retirees' health insurance.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. We pay 50%.
Mm-hmm. Right, yeah.
And we're only paying for the secondary policy. We're
That's
not
correct.
Paying for Medicare.
Half of the secondary.
Half of the secondary policy.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So we're going to continue to do this. What we're hedging by putting this money in is we might have a steep increase in any one year. Right now, $13,000, $14,000 is something we can deal with.
Mm-hmm.
But if it goes to $50,000,
right. That's
what we're hedging our bet. But I don't think it's going to happen.
My problem with this thing is the double standard. The state dictates and demands to us that we do this, and yet they don't do it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
They don't set the example. They just say, you do it, and we're going to exempt ourselves.
Because all the school, at least the frontier, is all on...
They should
different
have their own
program.
They should have their own OPEB.
They do.
They have their own.
They do.
But it's a lot higher percentage than 50-50.
I don't know whether, yes, probably is. Probably the 80-20.
That's what I was, it is 80-20. Pretty much the same.
Frontier is 80-20 retired?
I believe so.
Are you in the GIC?
Yes.
So you know this?
Well, no, it doesn't.
The agency that I work for paid my health insurance, that portion.
Can I ask for a call to question?
Yes.
No, because we'll have to take a vote if you do that.
I know that.
So if there are no further questions, all those in favor of $10,000 for OPEB, say aye.
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 Aye. All those opposed? It's unanimous?
$10,000.
Okay.
So we met the selectmen halfway.
They came down to us.
Yeah, I mean, so.
We can,
Was there anything else that we wanted to talk about?
Yeah, capital stabilization.
Capital stabilization.
Oh, yes, okay. Okay.
Well, before we get there, I mean, there's an article.
Thank you, Barbara.
Are we going to review articles and recommend articles that have money related to them?
There are a couple, yes.
Who's talked about it?
Go ahead.
Nobody's talked about it, yeah.
Well, the list here is most.
Yeah, but we haven't talked.
We're setting up reserve fund, revolving funds for, there's a blanket article for departments, doesn't say which ones.
Resources.
We can talk about.
I'd like to talk about all, any article that.
If.
Revolves money.
If you want.
We're supposed to review all articles.
All articles.
All articles.
Regardless of whether they're money or not.
We're not supposed to, we are authorized to if we so desire.
So we can, would not be required to recommend any article that has a financial burden to the town.
What's that?
We would not be required to recommend any article that could have a financial burden to the town.
Yeah,
We can and we should.
And should.
We can and should, that's correct.
Everybody's entitled to the finance committee's opinion.
And sometimes it's worthless.
Well, I wouldn't say that.
I mean, it depends.
It was last year.
Yeah, it was last year.
Okay, so we have the capital stabilization.
We'll make a motion, we approve capitalization for $200,000.
We haven't started anything yet.
Second.
What's that?
What did you say?
I'm sorry.
Okay, so this is a motion, a second.
Yeah, we made that motion?
Yeah.
Yeah, this.
I think you did.
That's why I said, wow.
First off.
I know, who made a second to that?
I did. My recollection of this whole capitalization stabilization fund was that it was going to be explicitly for buildings and their future.
I don't remember that.
I thought it was not going to have any designation.
No.
That's my understanding.
I thought it was going to be for building.
My understanding was that it was essentially intended to fund the following year's capital budget.
That's what we talked about.
That's what it is, yeah.
But I don't think that's a great idea. Only because now people know you got $200,000 in stabilization funds specifically for next year's capital items.
Still has to be approved by CIPC.
That's right.
And it still has to take a two-thirds vote to get it out.
Right, which is a good thing.
Which is a good thing.
So it goes through the.
It's a good thing.
It goes through the, and it also gives the town an idea of how much money is available. I mean, next year, you know, we may spend whatever we spend and not be able to put that much back into it. So that would reduce the amount that would be available the following year. But, you know, it gives us, I think it gives us a little more flexibility than we've had.
It's like a savings.
And hopefully it will keep us away from that habit that we had gotten into of waiting until the free cash had been certified.
Right.
And then a bunch of pigs at the trough trying to spend money, so.
Is that what it was?
Well, I think so. Close enough?
Yeah, close enough.
That was a good summary.
I want to just double check with you.
The pigs at the trough, you want me to say that again?
It's a good summary.
So. We have an increase this year, looks like there's a minor increase in our budget from last year to this year.
Total.
Do we have a relationship between tax rate last year and tax rate this year?
It's not.
Is it minor increase? Is that, so it's like 25, 30 cents?
We don't know because we don't know total assessed value, right?
We'll know until.
So which one are we talking, are you talking about the tax levy?
I'm just, yeah, I'm talking about tax levy.
Okay.
Everything sort of shows.
That tax levy calculation is the same. We could go out, we could do this for the next 20 years and we would be, the only thing that changes is the new growth, basically.
Every year for 2.5% because we have enough in tax levy.
and then whatever the new growth is.
Right.
And that typically has added up to about 3%. And then the debt exclusion, that's added on top of it, so.
I'm with you there, but I'm just.
I think he's talking about the rate.
Well, yeah, we really haven't.
With the rate.
Okay, fine, we.
Typically, in most every year, they've gone right to the maximum. They've left there actually very little on the table.
Actually, you've got those figures someplace.
I do, I don't have those.
Yeah, so, I mean, I think in, you know, the years I was on it, it varied anywhere from 2% to 5% as far as the.
Depending on how much we had in.
Either gain or loss of valuation.
Gain or loss of valuation, right, but it all depended on what we voted for in debt exclusion, too.
Well, yeah.
That's all part of the pot.
That's part of the pot, yes.
So we continue to build buildings at 3 million, 2 million, that type of thing. Our taxes will go up substantially over and above this 2.5%.
Oh, they could anyway, you know, even.
As long as we continue this role. So my point is.
No, even without growth, even without building stuff, you can still see a 50%, you know. Take the worst case scenario, okay? Yankee Candle picks up and leaves town.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody's gonna make up for that.
Right.
So your taxes could jump 12% right there, okay? So it's not, you know, it depends on the valuation, though. You know, it's just too many things, you know. And the public really needs to know what we're going to be up against in the next 5 to 10 years. And I think the Capital Planning Committee is, you know, from what we've heard, is doing a good job of anticipating some of these things. And I think that needs, some of those stuff needs to be brought out. So people understand that, you know, they want to build these buildings and Taj Mahals and everything else, they're going to pay dearly for them.
So, to come back around to capital stabilization, why are we only putting $200,000 in? Well, we know we have $500,000 or $600,000 left in free cash.
We're better off leaving it in free cash so we can use it if we have to.
Use it for what?
Without our two-thirds.
But use it for what, though?
So whatever.
That's our rainy day fund in case we have a problem.
So it's actually part of next year's free cash.
Instead of the 1.5 million.
So we can spend it again to balance the budget.
Well, the $1.5 million, but that's, I mean, the free cash actually comes out of the other funds. It's where.
If you wanted, you could take $100,000 extra of our free cash and put it into our regular stabilization account.
You want to do that?
No. And there's a reason for that. The town considers Deerfield a rich community.
Right.
And why do they consider that? Because of our stabilization account, because of our free cash account, because of all the other accounts that we got. When you add it up, we got multiple millions of dollars worth of money, even though it's all tied up for different things. We're still a rich community. So what happens is they give other poor communities more money for schooling, and they take away from us.
I understand. But how can we be $1.5 million in free cash on a $15 million budget?
Oh, it's worse than that. It's on only that part. It's not the schools. We don't get anything back from the schools.
I understand.
So,
right.
So it's on the $5 million.
Oh, I know, on the
25% that we got.
Exactly. I mean, what are we doing here?
We're being conservative budgeting.
I guess we are.
Exactly.
I think
very conservative.
Bruce is making a very good point, bringing up a very good point here and that. And what makes me nervous is when people hear the term free cash and then take a look at that dollar amount, they don't understand. They just think that's all unencumbered. They think it's just spend time. We've got all this money. Why not spend it? And, you know, that's.
Who are you talking about? Town meeting or the town?
Generally, everybody.
Everybody on the street, even.
But that doesn't happen.
Well, oh, it doesn't? I've heard it. I've heard people say that frequently. Oh, I know it doesn't happen, but that's what I'm saying.
It's up to you. It's up to the right. Town meeting and all of that.
But people think that as well.
But people think that.
The general people do.
And it's really not cash in hand.
Exactly.
It's just like if you were running a business, it would be your retained earnings. It would be the. It would be the
taxes you've already paid.
Exactly.
Right.
Yes.
Right, exactly.
The what's the word I'm thinking of?
Free cash.
the strength, it basically, it's representing the strength of your community, the strength of your financials, more than anything to me.
You could look at these towns who have nothing.
Sort of.
Or very little.
Most cities have.
Oh, my God, what have they done?
I can remember 20 years ago when Springfield had a figure of a negative $25 million in free cash, negative.
Yeah, and when they brought the state in.
For 7 years, the state came in and.
And we all paid.
Oh, yeah, you never.
I guess my point is, I think I'd rather have a stabilization.
Give to them.
Than free cash.
Well, we are putting $200,000.
I know, yeah, we end up with $650,000.
Yes, I'm gonna put this guy on and this guy.
Well, actually, there's a little more.
$600,000.
But whatever it is.
Because I know you're conservative, that's why, that's a compliment.
Isn't there a lottery ticket called free cash, too?
Probably.
Our free cash, by the way, the.
That's something very different.
That number we're looking at on Brenda's calculations is going down fast tonight.
Yes, it is.
Because I just looked at the warrants, I mean, we need to put the $35,000 for the police.
$22,500 for the police.
Right.
Okay, but that needs to go.
And then we're looking at probably about $100,000, if I remember right, I don't have that figure on the top of my head, for snow and ice.
For what, grease it this year?
For the overage on snow and ice.
And then we probably did another what?
Pretty close.
How much did we do tonight that we voted departmental budgets? Another 30?
So we spent $180,000 or so.
We're down to $500,000.
We're knocking it down fast.
So I, like I said, don't quote me on that, but it's well over what our appropriation was. I thought it was close to double what the.
Yeah, you're right, it's probably down about $500,000, yeah. Versus the $658,000 we're looking at.
That's because we planned it that way. If anything goes wrong, you catch hell for it. So when you get something right, take the pat on the back.
Yeah.
I've gotten to the point where I tend to look to see that was a pat and not a knife.
$4.5 million town budget.
Can I ask for call the question on this $200,000?
Yeah, we got a motion on the table.
So do you need to talk about transferring stabilization?
I agree, Bruce.
Into capital, or that you're assuming that?
That's gonna be a separate stabilization account.
Right, are you gonna, but you're gonna, you're not gonna, where are you gonna get the money?
Free cash.
Okay, I thought you were gonna transfer some out of regular stabilization.
No, no.
No.
So what are you gonna spend out of regular stabilization?
Nothing.
Really?
Nothing.
Okay.
Then that should go back to reduce the tax rate then.
So if there are no further discussion on setting up or whatever we're doing, moving $200,000 into the capital stabilization account.
Say aye.
Say aye.
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 Aye. No? Anybody say no?
Nope.
So it's a 7-0 vote.
Yay.
Okay.
See that, we support you.
Do you need to do anything else tonight?
We've been talking about this one all year.
We've done enough tonight, it's going on 2 hours.
There's anything, oh, unless you wanted to go over the warrant articles, but there aren't really set at this point anyway.
If we go over the warrant articles, can we skip next Tuesday?
No.
Well, I'm hoping, I'm gonna have the board sign one of 5 different versions of the warrant tomorrow night.
They can always change the thing.
Well, it's gotta be posted Friday.
Well, are we gonna talk?
And I'm not sure again about if we're still putting ad in the paper, which I don't think we've done in the past, but did we put these in, the warrants in the newspaper?
You're asking the wrong people.
You have to for special, but not.
We gotta ask you that.
That's what we have a town administrator, ask the town administrator.
Well, I already resolved it, that was so many weeks ago, I've forgotten, so.
Maybe just quickly, Article 5.
Yep.
Sets up revolving funds for departments, it's not specific on limitations of those funds, is that all gonna be broken out?
This is a change.
That all comes in the motion, doesn't it, Wendy?
Yes, and, yeah, that'll be in the motion, and that's.
Certain departments will receive funds, revolving funds.
Those are revolving funds that you.
No, what's the purpose of that?
What's the purpose of?
Setting up revolving funds for certain departments.
It's not like they're being reset up, these are all, right?
Pre-existing ones, yeah.
All existing.
There was a change.
Funds that need to be.
Refunded?
It just has to be revoked annually.
Wendy, can you explain it, the municipal modernization bill changed how we approved that?
Yeah, okay.
Right, so this is actually.
to amend the bylaws to be consistent with the...
Question on that. Are they going to be presented as a lump sum, so, or are they each...
From what I saw of the suggested outline of it, we wrote them all just like we did the last time.
Yeah, but I'm just...
Separately.
So you would have to amend the whole bylaw that incorporates all these if you want to change one? Is against in setting up, you know, each revolving fund is a separate...
That's what I was thinking.
That makes sense.
You know what I'm trying to say?
Amending the bylaw now?
Well, if, no, no. If you put this through is lump sum revolving funds, which is the way it's kind of written right now, then somewhere down the road, say you want to get rid of Parks and Recreation.
The motion will, maybe I'm, because I thought you just said this, so I don't want to repeat what you said if I'm not getting it. But the motion will detail those, but this...
Right, but it's going to be a single bylaw to authorize all of these?
This, yeah, that's...
So what I'm saying is, if it's a single bylaw that authorizes all of these, if you want to change one of them, then you have to amend that whole...
I don't think so.
No.
This council has reviewed this line.
Isn't it, is the bylaw, it's just to set up the fact that you have revolving, right?
Right.
There's no amount in it.
Or designation of what those funds are. It all happens each year at the annual, at the...
Right, but this, because, this is setting them up permanently now. This is not, this is...
It's not going to be an annual.
There's not going to be, it's going to be a change of numbers. So now if you want to change or remove a one...
I know what you're saying.
Now you've got to go through the question and answer of, well, what about this fund? What about this fund? What about this fund? Rather than just saying, okay, this bylaw, we are going to change the revolving fund entitled recycling. I mean, it just, somewhere down, you know, you could open up a can of worms on the floor if you go to change one of these funds if they're all incorporated in the same bylaw. Does that make any sense?
Yep, I'm going to just verify that.
Is there any reason that we can't have it all under one article and then you can have separate motions for each one of the...
I think that's what we do.
The funds?
Oh, okay.
So each one comes in as a...
Right.
No, all right.
Separate, whether it's a bylaw or whatever, it's a separate...
Right.
Article or a separate section.
Since we've already been here 2 hours according to that clock...
It's time to go.
Well, I'm going to make a motion that we adjourn.
I'd be happy to stick around if anyone has individual questions about the warrant.
I'd like to meet next week and talk about the warrant. Just, I mean, I realize that this...
Well, there's a major item in there that potentially nobody's even talking about. We don't even know the dollar value. Article number 13.
Which one?
What is that?
What is it?
That's the SCIMS budget.
Article number 13 is...
Well, it's been moved around.
It's the water treatment facility.
Yep.
It's upgrades, repairs.
It's a placeholder. I don't know if we'll have anything.
It's the what article?
It says Article 13.
Capital items.
Wastewater treatment plant capital item.
That's just a...
Why just South Deerfield? What about Old Deerfield?
I have no idea what's going on.
It shouldn't say that. That's because the old article...
I know, but why is it...
The old article had specifically to do with the Headworks project. That's coming out. It's just going to be generic for the Deerfield...
But all that has to go through CIPC.
We'll take it off if we've got nothing. We'll take it off.
You've got nothing.
I just had it as a placeholder in case something...
You got nothing, no request for capital?
And the sewer...
No, but if it's not going to be, well, it's going to, if it's going to be raised through taxes, it has to go through us. If it's going to go like to sewer users, it does not.
Understood. But there's only an excess of about $70,000 this year. Looks like there might be an excess of $70,000 between operating budget.
That's really not a whole lot.
That's not...
For as much as it reaches.
As I said, look at the numbers.
Well,
maybe it could be different.
So is the sewer study committee recommending anything?
We don't recommend any articles.
Hopefully the readings come out so they can get bills in.
Now, is Article 13 strictly sewer reserves?
Yeah.
Funds?
That's what I guess.
That's the bottom line.
Because the town people can't vote on it.
Very complicated. I've talked to council about the question. getting a very detailed memo on that issue tomorrow.
So it raised appropriate.
Your question.
Isn't it? It could be an issue.
That's, yeah, that's saying that everybody pays.
Right.
Not just sewer users.
I don't think we're ready to.
I'm just asking.
That's what it's, that's what it leads up to.
I kept it there as a placeholder in case the, you came up with the project.
Well, our last sewer study committee, amongst our sewer study committee, and you had both septic and users, we agreed that it wouldn't be appropriate to bring that to town meeting floor yet. Is that my understanding, everybody, or?
No, bring it here.
We decide to hold on that for the time being, as far as making a recommendation?
If we would recommend anything, we'd recommend it to bring it to the next special town meeting. That's what I think we talked about.
Well, you guys have a quorum here, so you can.
No, we can't.
Not posted.
No.
So you want me to remove this article?
No, I don't want you, I just want you to be, to clarify whatever's gonna happen.
Well, that, actually, I kept it on for you to clarify.
The sewer study committee?
Well.
We don't rate.
I'm trying to.
We don't make recommendations.
Get information from those who.
There's a whole bunch of capital.
Needs to come out.
In any event.
Okay, I think you're right.
It could very well. I would like to meet next week and look at whatever articles you'd like to look at. I mean, it would have been nice if we could have done this two or three weeks ago, but we weren't there.
You have to post the warrant by Friday, right?
Yes.
It's all right, we can still look at them because we can, you know, we can either make recommendations or not.
We're not changing the warrant.
We're changing it. Remember, that's all we're doing.
I go through this.
We're recommending.
So we have the clarity on some of these articles.
So, you know, we may at that point in time just say, you know, forget it, let's move to the next one. We may find one or two that we want to put some sort of a recommendation to.
Well, I guess my question would be, why is Article 13 on there in the first place?
You should just put it in there.
It's a placeholder.
It was on there from the special, or the, yeah.
The one we've.
Right, when you did the headworks, when you were anticipating that. I left it there as a placeholder in the event something came up.
But that was out of sewer reserves.
But that was out of sewer reserves, so that we voted.
You still had it as an article in the.
Yeah, but you can't say raise and appropriate, because then you're gonna have non-sewer users paying for it.
It usually says raise and appropriate or take from available.
All articles say that.
Right, that's true.
The motions will detail, but all the articles all say that, so I am taking that off.
Okay.
The motion will come through and say what.
That sounds like a good idea. In the meantime, all those in favor of adjourning? Aye?
Aye.
Aye.
So maybe one of those.
I'd be happy.
Anybody second?
I would be happy.
Anybody second?